coming in. A little bit old, a little bit light. He's gone for the top of the neck as well, and this, so he's obviously in the team. Trish now coming in. Yep, she's thinking the England rugby team. Yes, he's an England candidate as well, definitely. Dennis now determined to make an effort. He's coming in a little bit lower. Circus. Oh, and he's tested the goal a little bit. Another reload in goal. Ladies flying, remember. Oh, she's only doing the one this time. Tom now coming in. Bit of side slip. Yes, straighten it out. Get your height right. There he goes on one, and straight on through. But oh no, he's pulled out the second one. I think she'll have watched John very carefully, so she's certainly going to miss the first one. Power off, let's see if it's going to go. Is she happy? She's happy. And there we are, nicely done. Hilda Hewlett would have been proud.
Two yellow balloons came up a bit late there.
Phil learned to fly at the RAF Cromwell Flying Club about 6 years ago, and very soon got forward with a very benign bubble jumping aircraft that the club used as a trainer, and then bought himself a rather old S1. Unbelievably, he managed to teach himself aerobatics flying this little aircraft whilst utilising his skills as a technician, and kept the aircraft in tip-top condition, and over the first season actually started to win some prizes. Limitations of that aircraft very soon started to hold him back in the competition. The real one to have the Phil's tie is a smaller version. It has to stop the edge. This display has Phil's tie. It's coming up at 220 miles an hour.
Thank you. are flying in displays, but this is an original from 1940. The story of the aircraft is a strange one.
Lands 25 26 positions for his display, and up to the end of the runway we have our next participant. thoroughbred aerobatic aircraft. Molded from carbon fibre. Passing forward.
Thank you. Yeah, sorry. They weren't there when we first met.